The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. No man is an island, the poet says, but it's probably true that each man would like to own one. Yes, a little out-of-the-way island, a little piece of paradise where every prospect pleases, where he may be a king who rules supreme. Is it possible to find such a place? Some people do.
This is Henry calling K3356. Henry calling Bart, K3356. Come in, Bart.
Bart,
you know the people I told you about, dressed in furs with long hair and spears? The ones I'm watching from the boat.
Yes, Henry.
I thought somebody was shooting a movie. It's not a movie. They're coming toward the beach.
You better get out of there.
I can't. I'm stuck. It's low tide, Bart. They're pointing spears at me. What am I going to do?
Mystery drama, A God Named Henry, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Ralph Bell. I'll be back shortly with Act One. What is that proverb? The wheel that squeals the loudest is the one that gets the grease. Yes. And the fact is, the wheel that gets the grease isn't necessarily the one that does the work. Well, one of the quietest of wheels is the hero of our little tale, Mr. Henry Clay Fitzsimmons. And we shall see, he gets no grease at all from anybody.
Yes, come in, Henry. I understand you want to talk to me.
I do, R.J. You know how it is today. Everything's gone up sky high. The prices. My wife was saying to me, Henry, it's getting to be impossible.
Yeah, the bottom line is you want more money.
I guess that's right.
No, that's wrong, Henry. Wrong. Why do you suppose we have this inflation, this terrible, destructive inflation?
Well, R.J.
Because everybody's got his hand out for more, more, more.
Well, it's just that Doran, I can't...
Oh, I understand, Henry. But it's got to stop. It has to be turned around, somewhere, somehow, and by somebody. And do you know who that somebody is? You.
Me?
That's right, me. Every one of us is a me, and every one of us has got to say, I am going to stop it.
R.J., I...
Why do I say this to you, Henry? Because you were just promoted production foreman. You are now a part of management. You and I are the management team. We have to set the example to the labor force. Make do, Henry. That's going to be the slogan around here. Make do or do without. We're fighting for our lives.
Henry, did you talk to him today?
Talk to who?
Who do you think? R.J.
Oh, yeah.
Well, what did he say?
About what, Dora?
About what? About the price of flower pots in Patagonia.
I asked for the raise.
And?
He said no.
Well, did you quit?
How could I quit?
How could you ask for a raise unless you're prepared to walk out?
Dora, it's all very well for you to say quit. Where would I get another job?
Go out and look.
Other people have been out of work for months.
I don't want to hear about other people. Sit still. I'll answer it. Hello?
Yeah, this is R.J. Is this Dora?
Why? Do you think he might be living with some other woman?
Is that R.J.?
I love your sense of humor, Dora. Is Henry there?
He's in the middle of dinner, R.J.
Yeah, well, this is very important.
Will you let me talk to him?
Hold on, please.
R.J.?
Henry, I would have gotten in touch with you earlier, but I was busy at the club. We just got a rush order from Grand National. They'll need a couple of thousand cases by noon tomorrow.
Oh, I don't know how we can do that. The number three production line is down.
Well, how long would you need to make it operational?
4 or 5 hours.
Well, I think you'd better go in and do it tonight.
Tonight? Oh, boy.
They're the best customer we have. You're part of management, Henry. You can understand the problem.
Yeah. All right. I'll go in.
I knew I could depend on you.
Night work, huh?
You can't say no to a customer like Grand National.
You can't?
Because if you do, they'll have to go somewhere else. I'd better hurry, Dora.
Sure.
What are you going to do tonight?
Oh, I may go out.
Where?
I don't know.
You going to go to a show with the girls?
I'm sick of going to shows with the girls. What I'd like to do is go to a show with the boys.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
Henry, I'm sick and tired of your working overtime, nights and weekends. I'm tired of being alone.
Just a minute.
I want to go places, have some fun. If not with you, I'm just going to find somebody else.
Now, this is serious. We have to talk about it.
Yes. Let's talk about it right now.
I can't.
Why not?
Because I have to go to work.
That's the problem, isn't it?
Listen, I could be finished with this thing. It doesn't have to be much past 9 o'clock. It's a great night. You could meet me down at the dock. We could take the boat out.
You want to go sailing at night? You can go by yourself.
But it's the only free time I have.
We have now come to the end of the reel. What do you want to do? Rewind it so we can go through these same stupid arguments over and over again?
Hi there, Henry.
Hello, Bart.
Well, you taking her out tonight?
Yeah.
Ah, look at them clouds around the moon.
They don't look too bad.
Yeah, they're going to start looking worse about a couple of 3 hours from now. I'd hate to be out there in a 21-foot sailboat.
It'll blow over.
Why do you have to take her out tonight?
My boss is on me all the time. Do this, do that. My wife starts in where he leaves off.
Mm.
If I don't get away from it this way, I'd go nuts.
Yeah, but even so, if I was you, I'd stay ashore tonight.
Come in, Henry. Come in.
Bart, this is Henry.
I told you. I warned you.
I'm okay. The minute the wind came up, I headed right for shore.
Where you at?
I found a nice little protected inlet just south of Sutter's Cove.
Inlet just south of Sutter's? How far?
2 miles, maybe.
I never heard of no inlet around there.
Neither did I, but here I am.
Well, if you're okay, you just stay there and wait it out.
Bart, I was asleep.
In a storm like this?
What storm?
Where'd you say you are?
This little inlet south of Sutter's Cove.
But I told you, south of Sutter's, there's nothing.
It's about 15 feet wide. Goes in, as far as I can see, a couple of hundred yards. I'm tied up to some trees.
Well, check to see if you're secure. Storm's getting worse.
Are you kidding? It's a beautiful morning. There's hardly a ripple on the water. Hey. Hey, what's that?
Henry?
I hear something. It sounds like drums.
Thunder, more likely.
No. They're drums. I can see between the trees. There's a big clear space. I see people. Hey, but they're dressed funny. They're wearing skins.
Skins?
Skins, you know, for furs. And the guy...
The guys have got long hair and beards. They're carrying spears.
Henry?
Hey, you know what this has to be? The movie. They're making a movie. I'll go watch. I'll call you back.
This is Bart. Come in.
Bart, they're not making a movie.
Who's not making a movie?
These people I'm telling you about, they're dressed in the skins with the long hair carrying the spears.
I've never heard you this drunk in all the years I've known you.
They're not actors. They're for real. There are no cameras or anything. Uh-oh. They're approaching the boat. I better talk to them. I'll try to keep you posted.
Yeah, sure. You do that.
Well, what can I do for you folks?
Thera.
Thera? Oh, you mean your name is Thera?
Thera.
Okay. You can call me Henry.
Henry.
Henry, yeah. You got it. So, what's it all about? Who are you folks? What are you doing? Well, stop it. You don't have to get down on your knees.
Henry.
Yeah, Henry. That's been established. I'm Henry.
You are Henry.
You speak English. Where did you learn?
From Henry. Henry is God.
What God?
The God, Henry. He looks at us and he reveals to us English. Now the people can understand the God, Henry, in English.
English.
The words of God.
Hey, friends, you just dialed the wrong number. I'm not a god or anywhere near it. I'm just some poor guy in a sailboat who happened to blunder into this place.
Behold, Malana, she comes.
Well, who's Malana?
See, Malana, she carries her small child. She brings him to the god, Henry.
To me? What for?
The child is dying.
Oh, he sure doesn't look too good. It's all flushed. Must be burning up with a fever. This lady's his mother? Say, I better get this kid to a doctor. What do you say? Oh, I guess she doesn't speak English, huh?
She is not permitted to speak with the god.
Oh, no?
Only I, Thera, may speak with the god, Henry.
Oh, well, why is that?
The people have chosen me to be his priestess. And how is it said in English? Concubine.
Hey, listen, I got a wife.
Gods have many wives.
Well, never mind all that for now. That kid has to go to a hospital. I'll take him in the boat.
No.
No?
Malana will kill herself.
Why?
Because you will place him in the god boat and take him to the sky.
No, I'll take him to the Cedarville General Hospital.
No, the god Henry must cure the child here. The people wait.
Let's get this straight. I never said I was able to...
Henry must cure the child, or the people will turn on their god.
Turn on their god? What does that mean? Killed?
Cure the child.
But how?
By a miracle.
A miracle? How can you expect me to make a miracle?
You cannot make a miracle. It will prove that you are a false god. The people wait.
We're all going to wait, and all of us should hope or pray that Henry can come up with that miracle. We have a branch of our military service that says the difficult we do right away, the impossible takes a little bit longer. A pity they're not here. We'll have to wait for Act Two, which will be here shortly. Consider the situation in which Henry Clay Fitzsimmons finds himself. He blunders into an island, or a place that seems to be populated by prehistoric savages. There is good news and bad. The good news is that they wish to worship him as a god. The bad news, if he doesn't perform an instant miracle, they will kill him as a devil.
But a miracle?
Why should a miracle be difficult for a god?
What do you want me to do?
Cure the child.
I'm not a doctor.
You're even greater. A god.
We just keep going round and round with this thing.
The people wait. Shall the miracle begin?
Miracle. Miracle. Miracle drugs. Say, I've got some aspirin, the first aid kit, and also some antibiotics left over from the time I hold everything.
There will be a miracle.
Yes.
How?
I have magic food for the child to eat.
People, behold. See, the skin of the child is now dry and cool. The fever no longer rages through his body. The devils have been driven out. The child, Melana's child, sleeps peacefully. There has been a miracle. All kneel before the true god, Henry.
Come in, Henry.
Bart?
Henry, come in.
Bart?
You okay? It's getting worse, the storm.
What storm?
Hey, you really must be pretty snug in that inlet.
Yeah, I guess you could say I am.
Well, stay there. I'll try to venture out.
You know something, Bart, old buddy? I may stay here quite a while.
What?
You just can't beat being a god.
A what? A what?
Bart? Bart? Come in, Bart. Oh, she shorted out. Radio's dead. Gone. Well, what difference? What have I got to say to anyone anyhow? And what does anyone have to say to me? What are the drums for?
A woman.
What about her?
She is to be destroyed.
You mean killed?
Yes.
Why?
She has displeased the god Henry.
I don't remember being displeased by anyone. Who is she?
Thera.
That's you?
Yes.
I'm not displeased with you.
Oh, yes. The god is displeased with me. And everyone knows it.
What does everyone know?
The god has been among us here for 1 month.
A month? Have I been a month? How could that be?
And he has not yet taken his priestess and concubine into his marriage bed.
Oh.
Nor has he told his people to prepare the nuptial cave. Therefore, since the priestess Thera does not please the god Henry, the people must destroy her and select a new priestess concubine who will find favor in his heart.
It seems to me you people do a lot of killing around here.
Is there another way?
Oh, I don't go for that. And if I'm going to be boss, there'll have to be some changes made. Get all the people together.
People, the god Henry will speak.
I have an announcement to make. From this point on, there's not going to be any more killing around here. Is that understood?
The people will ask, if there is to be no killing, how will disputes be settled?
We're going to have a set of rules. I'm going to sit down and write them out. And everybody's got to learn them. Is that understood?
It will be understood.
The thing won't be too complicated. Actually, it'll just be based on don't do to the next fellow what you wouldn't want him to do to you.
What is the god Henry doing?
I'm trying to fix this radio.
Oh, yes. We heard it speak on the day you came here. Is this how the gods talk to each other?
I've been gone about a month.
does the god miss heaven?
I went sailing on my boat on a night I should have stayed ashore. Why'd I go? Well, I had to get away. Why'd I always feel that I had to get away? Why couldn't I have a happy home, a happy job?
But the god is happy now.
Oh, yeah, why not? I'm placed on a pedestal. My word is law. I have a beautiful woman who keeps throwing herself at me. Yeah, what am I trying to fix this thing for? What do I care about what's happening back there?
I don't see a thing, Dora. You?
No, I don't.
Yeah, shut her off. Drift for a bit.
You spoke to Henry on the radio. He said he was here?
Said he'd found an inlet about 2 miles south of Sutter's Cove. We haven't seen a thing.
Bart, what could have happened to him?
Well, it was a pretty bad storm, Dora. It lasted 3 days. Nothing could live out in the open ocean. Certainly not a 21-foot sailboat.
Maybe something else happened. Maybe he became fed up with me and decided to disappear.
Oh, now, Dora.
I haven't been a good wife.
What do you mean?
You know what a good wife is, Bart.
Don't ask me. I never got married.
She's one who knows how to hide her disappointment. You marry a guy because you think he's... Well, you think he's a god. And then when you find out he's only a guy, you get mad at him. I thought he was all iron and steel, and it turns out he's just milk and water.
No, I wouldn't say that, Dora.
I would. The abuse he took from his boss. Oh, I should have let him alone. If he didn't have the guts to stand up for his rights, it must have made him feel miserable enough. Why did I keep rubbing it in? Didn't do him any good.
Hey, Dora. You talk like you'll never see him again.
Do you think we'll ever see him again?
No.
I just can't understand what's wrong with the radio.
Does the god Henry still try to fix the magic box?
Well, something inside is loose or broken.
Does my lord miss his other gods in heaven?
Oh, my heaven is right here.
When shall my lord go back?
Who said anything about that?
They all go back. All the gods who visit.
You mean there have been other gods?
They stay. We worship them, and then they leave us. Why? Can it be explained?
Well, these people, these gods, as you call them, they have homes, they have families, responsibilities.
I do not understand responsibility.
Well, that's because you people don't have them.
And the gods?
I was a production foreman. I was the key guy in the plant. 80 jobs depended on me. 80 men, 80 families. I was able to keep the machinery going so that R.J. could keep the plant running.
R.J.?
He was another god. A big one. Dora and I, we just bought the house. It's got a mortgage. How's she going to keep up the payments?
My lord is sad.
And I've got this responsibility to the battalion.
The battalion?
The 898th Engineer Battalion of the Massachusetts National Guard. I'm an officer. I think it's important.
So many things are important to a guard.
And there's a lot of things you miss. Movies. Some of them, anyhow. Pizza.
Pizza.
TV. I only watch half the stuff now and then. And, going to the Red Sox games?
The Red Sox.
And, bowling. There's so much.
My lord will tell his Thera of these things.
How could I tell you? How could I make you understand? It's something you have to have lived with, be part of.
All this then formed the heaven of my god, Henry. Henry?
It made me what I am.
When does my lord intend to return to his heaven?
Oh, I didn't say I was returning. I've been here, 6 months now? I never had a beard like this. I found a new world. A new life.
I'm not leaving.
Then destroy the magic voice box.
Why?
Because if it is permitted to speak, it will tell the god Henry to return.
Vera, I just want to know what's happening back there.
Vera has been happy. She's grateful for even this brief time.
I didn't say I was going. Oh, hey, I found it. This wire just has made contact. That's it. I don't know about the transmitter, but I ought to be able to receive.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Lou Bodie with the 6 o'clock news.
6 o'clock? Evening? Hey, what's wrong? It's just about noon.
First, the local scene. Still missing is Henry Clay Fitzsimmons of Cedarville.
Missing?
6 days ago, Henry left Bart's Marina in his 21-foot sailboat.
6 days ago?
A few hours later, the storm of near-hurricane velocity struck and ravaged our coast for 3 days.
What's he talking about?
During the worst of it, he was in communication with Bart's Marina. He claimed to have found a sheltered spot. The mystery is why he hasn't been heard from as soon as the storm was over. It is now 6 days, and there's absolutely no sign of him or his boat. The Coast Guard is continuing the search. More news after this message.
Am I hearing this right? I've been gone 6 days? That's been 6 months. I've been keeping track. I've got a notebook. Here, look.
My lord is troubled.
Could I have grown a beard like this in 6 days? Hey, somebody has to be crazy.
Why is my lord troubled?
They got the Coast Guard out and everything out. How could they make such a mistake? Unless...
My lord?
Oh, no. No, I don't want to think about it. Yeah, but I got to think about it. Unless this is a different world. A world where time isn't the same. Do you understand, Thera?
I'm not sure.
It isn't the same kind of time. That's the only answer.
But that's the kind of answer that raises more questions. We thought there was only one kind of time. True, you can arbitrarily decide to cut it up into time zones, standard time and daylight saving, or anything and everything you like. But it still remains the same kind of time, measurable by the same instruments. Is there another kind? You'll have to explain it as soon as we return with Act Three. A book of verses beneath the bough, a loaf of bread, a jug of wine, and thou, beside me in the wilderness, would be paradise enow. Well, we cut Mr. Fitzgerald's poem up a bit to serve our purpose, but you get the idea. Paradise. Everyone has his own vision of how he would want it, which is no guarantee that he'd be happy with it if he ever got it.
This is another world. Another world, Thera.
Yes.
And everything about it is different. Different. Even time.
Time?
Time. You know what time is? Very simply, time is the stuff of your life. You understand? Time is the only thing you have.
Why is my lord so frightened?
Oh. Well, you heard what Lou Bodie said just before.
The god who spoke from the magic box?
Yeah, well, back home, 6 days is the same as 6 months here. You know what that means? One of your years is about the same as one of our months. I'm 35. The Bible says I'm entitled to live to 70. Here, I would become 70 in 35 more months.
Then my lord is truly leaving?
Oh, I've got to, Thera. Oh. But there's no reason I can't come back occasionally for a short visit to see you again. Bring in all sorts of stuff that the people need.
No. Once the god goes back, he does not return.
Oh, I would have to return to you, Thera.
Then do not leave.
I have to.
Yes, I understand.
Here, I want you to have this.
What is it?
It's my watch. Take it.
What is a watch?
It tells the time. The time of the day.
Oh, the time is captured by the watch.
You could say that.
And the watch keeps it. And we never see that time again.
You know, in a way, that's true. Oh, look, here, the tide is changing. I'll have to float on it. Goodbye.
Goodbye, my lord.
I'll be back. You'll see. I'll be back.
Henry! Henry!
Bart,
here, toss me that rope. Got it. Well, home is a sailor, home from the sea, and so forth. Hey, listen, pal. What kind of story are you going to tell?
Story?
Whatever you do, don't hand your boss, RJ, or your wife the line you gave me.
What line?
Well, first, you were supposed to have run into this movie company on location.
Oh, that was because I...
Sure. And then you shifted gears and claimed it was some kind of primitive tribe.
It's true.
Yeah, but you don't have to explain to me. I'm not your problem.
Problem?
RJ, your friendly neighborhood capitalist, is loaded for bear. And Dora, oh, has that quiet, resigned look that could very well foreshadow the kiss of death.
But why?
Henry, you got into that boat of yours. You took off for almost a week. 3 days of it, okay, you're covered. We had a hurricane. But what about those other 3-4 days? What did you have going for yourself?
So, RJ is loaded for bear, huh?
I would say double-shotted.
Why?
Oh, look, we've already gone through that. You just went and took off.
Do you have any idea how much time he owes me?
Look, I'm just giving you the news.
And Dora doesn't like it either because I wasn't home, huh?
Hey, Henry.
And if I were home, would she be thrilled about it? Did she ever want to be with me? Come out on the boat? Go bowling? Watch the Red Sox?
Yeah, just simmer down, huh?
What for? Who needs this? Why should I have to put up with all this abuse?
Come on, buddy.
RJ pounding at me, Dora whining at me.
What's gotten into you?
Who needs this? Why, I could be a god. Why'd I come back here?
Henry?
I panicked. That was my problem. I just didn't think. How long have I been gone, Bart?
A week.
There, it was 6 months.
There? Where?
Oh, what's the difference? I still got my full-time value. Every hour was still 60 minutes. Every day was still 24 hours. Every year would still be 365 days.
Henry, you're starting to scare me.
Here, look at my beard.
What beard?
I've got a 6-month beard.
Oh. Well, you got the 6 days' growth.
It proves I'm right. It was all relative. So, why'd I come back here to all this?
How'd you like a drink?
I don't humor me.
Look, we've always been pals, huh?
Right, pals. And I'll show you what a pal I really am. I'm going to cut you in on this.
Huh? How'd you like to be a god? Depends on the pay. The hours.
It's not a joke.
Oh, Henry.
You really have a great life here, huh? Pumping gas, doing repairs, taking all kinds of guff from everybody, working day and night. What for, Bart? What for?
It's a living.
Don't call it a living. It's a dying.
Oh, Henry.
You want to live? You come out there with me. You'll do things that mean something. You'll be appreciated.
And the women. Women?
What women? They're not spoiled. They look up to you. They can't do enough for you. Let me prove it to you.
Sure.
It can't be more than 6 miles from here, just south of Sutter's Cove.
Look, there is nothing south of Sutter's Cove.
Let's take your launch. I'll prove it. It has to be here. I know the inlet has to be right here.
I don't see it.
It was here.
Look, Henry, I've been sailing these waters all my life. I never saw any inlet south of Sutter's Cove.
Hey, I made a sighting, okay? The reef, Thatcher's Mountain over there, and this big tree. Right here, along the bank. Hey, give me the rope.
Yeah.
We'll tie up for a minute.
Well?
But it was here. I tell you, it was here.
Okay. I'm only asking. So what happened to it?
Vera! Tell the people Henry has come back. The god Henry has come back. Vera?
I don't think there's anybody around, Henry.
No. Look.
Hmm?
Look. In the grass next to the tree. It's my watch. My watch?
Yeah. It looks like it, all right.
What do you mean, looks like it? See, it has my initials on it.
Okay, Henry, I won't deny it. Your watch.
I gave it to her. I gave Thera my watch. Here it is. Doesn't this prove I'm telling the truth?
Henry, it proves that you were here. You're tied up to this tree. You rode out the storm.
Oh, yeah? And what did I do with the rest of the time?
Well, that's for you to tell me.
The watch. How do you account for the watch?
I'm not the one who has to account for the watch. Come on. Let's go back.
You know what I think, Bart? There's another world. It exists right alongside our own.
Do you want to untie the rope and hop on board?
Maybe it's another dimension.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the violence of the storm revealed an entrance to it. But it's here.
Seeing's believing.
Well, whether you see it or not, it's here. The land of the people. It's here. All around us. Somewhere there's a warp or a bend or a hole through which you can go. Through which I went. Do you understand?
It doesn't get any better, Henry.
Thera and the people. They could be standing right there. And we don't see them. And they don't see us. But you've got to believe me.
I believe you. That's because we're old pals. But don't spring this on anyone else. Or they'll call for the guys in the white coats.
Dora.
Oh, it's you, RJ. Come in.
Where is he?
I don't know.
You mean he hasn't come home yet? Oh, someone noticed his boat was back at the marina.
It was?
Yes. We should have quite a confrontation.
Now, please, RJ. Now, that job means everything to him.
He's not going to get away with this.
I realize that now. Oh, maybe if I'd have understood it before, things might have been different.
He has to be taught a lesson.
I beg you, don't fire him.
He can't fire me. I quit.
Henry!
Where were you? What's the meaning of this?
I don't owe you any explanations.
Why, this is...
Please, RJ. Henry doesn't look well.
And you sit down, Dora.
Now, that's no way to talk to your wife.
Henry, that's really no way to talk to your boss.
What do you mean, you quit? What are you going to do for a living?
I'm not interested in doing anything for a living. I want to get rich. So I'm going to open a factory across the street from yours and put you out of business.
Why, of all this?
You think I couldn't, huh? All right, why bother? Why don't we just renegotiate my deal, RJ?
Henry, you're not feeling well. You see, RJ, he was on the boat all week. Probably became a little delirious.
I haven't been feeling well for a long time, Dora. Because I had a wife who felt I was a nobody.
Henry,
why shouldn't she? I always acted as if I were a nobody. As for you, R.J., I made it possible for you to run your business with all that broken down, obsolete machinery. I kept the factory going with rubber bands and sticking tape. What are you going to pay me for what I'm worth? Or we're quits?
No, just sit down. We have to talk about this, Henry.
I don't want to talk anymore today. I want to go sailing.
Bartz, I have to check out the wiring on my radio.
Look at you. You got fire in your eye.
Well, why not? All of us gods are filled with fire.
Is that a fact?
I guess the fire's what makes us gods to begin with.
Uh-oh. Look who's coming down the dock. Excuse me.
I thought I'd like to go sailing with you this afternoon.
Okay.
Henry, about everything.
Look, Dora, how can a man expect his wife to have any respect for him if she sees everyone else walk all over him?
I'm sorry.
I just didn't have any confidence.
I should have realized that, Henry, and tried to help you. But I always dreamed I'd marry a man who was... Now, don't laugh. Who was like a god. Oh, I realize now I was so foolish.
Don't say that. This dream of yours, how do you know it can't come true?
Oh, I'll settle for you, Henry.
We'll, be happy?
I know we will be.
We'll be happy, Thera. We'll be very happy.
Thera?
We both had dreams. And who's to say they won't come true?
Husbands, wives. Who was it that said, if you can't get what you like, you'd better like what you get? Thera, huh? Was she really Dora all the time? Was it all his dream? How can we ever know? I shall return shortly. The only world there is? Are there others coexisting with our own? Are there ever noises we cannot account for? Disappearances we simply cannot explain? Do you ever have the feeling that someone is watching? Is there an opening between the worlds? Who knows? If there is, it might not be advisable or safe to find it. Our cast included Ralph Bell, Joan Shea, and Roy Owens. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Don't listen to a spin.
Why, Elizabeth? Why are you diving?
No, Justin, don't you?
Say it, Elizabeth.
Because I don't wish to live without you. I don't want any substitute. Final mind and power and honor and what is best for mankind. I don't want any of that. I don't care about that. Let mankind take care of itself.
Do you wish to be with me, Elizabeth, in my dimension? A universe of rays, of light, of knowledge.
I want to be with you, Justin. I do.
Even if it means extinction?
Justin, save me for myself. Can you come back?
Are you sure you wish to die, Elizabeth?
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.